rain today, also a few thunderstorms. We're going to continue to see a very wet pattern this week, on and off rain and storms that could lead to possible flooding, along with cooler temperatures and mostly cloudy skies. I'll have all the details coming up.
Now at 10, Juneteenth celebrations across the nation, how Augusta is honoring Freedom Day. And an organization working to help African American people find their roots. And summertime is usually all fun and games, but it may cause some students to have a summer slide. We'll give you tips on how to prevent it as your News at 10 starts now.
Live from Television Park, this is WJBF News Channel 6 at 10 on BTV.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dee Griffin. Thanks so much for joining us. Coverage full time now for a first look at our weather. And meteorologist Jennifer Tronchi joins us now. Well, finally, we got a break in the rain.
Yeah, we definitely had a lot come through today, especially in the morning. We had some thunderstorms as well, but fortunately, no severe weather and no flooding concerns today either, since the rain was very fast moving. And now on My Viper 6, here's the last of the rain, at least for now. We have some spotty showers in Barnwell and Allendale County. Some brief heavy rain that just is exiting Bamberg County now. Other than that, we are nice and dry. Here's a look across the southeast. Areas of scattered showers and storms anywhere from Tennessee off the coast. Also, a lot of rain down in the Gulf Coast. Southern Mississippi and Alabama got a lot of that today. Right now on our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview Cam, though, at Augusta Regional Airport, not seeing any rain. We do have some cloudy skies, though, and those clouds limited our temperatures today, only making it to a high of 85 degrees, well below average. So even though the first day of summer is coming up on Wednesday, it will not be feeling like it. Temperatures right now, though, typical summertime evening with those temperatures in the low 70s. 73 in Barnwell, Augusta at 72, Aiken at 73, 71 in Louisville, so pretty consistent anywhere from those low to mid 70s. The dew points are also in the low 70s, also some upper 60s, so another muggy night. Humidity will be very high all week long as we have a lot of moisture in place producing those showers and storms. Other than the rain, we do have those very cloudy skies, except for our northern counties. Pretty clear right now with a warm front situated across the area. Low pressure in the Midwest, and this is what's producing all the active weather. We have severe thunderstorms ongoing now in parts of Louisiana and Mississippi. Now for tomorrow morning, we'll start out dry, mostly cloudy outside. Could see an isolated shower or storm or two. Other than that, temperatures in the upper 60s with more rain headed our way later on. So a gloomy week in store, rounds of showers and storms, some that could be strong, but no longer a threat of severe weather, and our highs only in the lower 80s. Coming up, I'll have all the details on your forecast, but back to you, Dee.
All right, Jenna, thanks so much. Well, hundreds of people came out to...
Are you too hot? Beat the summer heat with a window AC unit from Davis Appliance and Furniture for as low as $299. We offer a cool, no credit needed financing option to meet your needs. For the brand you trust at the lowest prices in town, visit us at Davis Appliance and Furniture.
The CSRA.
Welcome to Davis Appliance and Furniture, where you can find the best deals in town. We offer new and used appliances and we service what we sell. We offer no credit needed financing and delivery options to meet your needs. The top brands, the lowest prices in town, visit us at Davis Appliance and Furniture.
Now, your most accurate forecast with WJBF Live Viper 6.
Good Monday evening. I hope you dodged all the rain today and stayed dry. We definitely had our fair share of rain and storms come through, especially in the morning. None of them became severe, though, so that's good news. And right now, we're just seeing those showers exit Bamberg County, also seeing some pop-up showers and storms down in Emanuel County, and this will begin to expand and cover more of our area, but more on that to come. The rest of the CSRA looking good with scattered showers and storms all around our area, and especially down in Mississippi, right along the Gulf Coast is where there's a lot of heavy rain and one severe thunderstorm warning. So it's very active across the southeast. This will continue over the next few days. In Augusta, just under a half an inch of rain, but just to our north and west, 3 to 4 inches, almost 12 inches recorded around Mobile, Alabama. So luckily for us, we had no flooding concerns today, and as I mentioned, no severe storms either. On our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview Cam at the Amentum Center in Aiken, it's dry outside, cloudy skies still, 72 degrees as our temperature, so a warm and muggy summer-like evening, 69 degrees as our dew point with a southeast wind of 3 miles per hour. So we're seeing all low 70s right now, very consistent across the board, 71 in Thompson and Gibson, Lincolnton at 73, Edgefield and Saluda at 72, and 73 as well in Barnwell. Cloudy skies for everyone, a little bit of clearing in some of our northern counties, but tomorrow morning expect more clouds with more rain headed our way as well. This is all due to this low-pressure system that'll become a cutoff low, bringing more chances of storms over the next few days. And on our water vapor loop, you can really see that counterclockwise spin there with the dry air on one side of it where there's no rain right now in Alabama and parts of northern Mississippi. But for our neck of the woods, a lot of moisture in place from that system. So we'll continue to see this tropical moisture pump into the CSRA with this cutoff low stalling out, keeping the rain and cooler temperatures over the next few days. So more on that to come, but let's switch gears to the tropics. We had tropical storm Brett form earlier today, 40-mile-per-hour winds right now. It is going to gradually strengthen to a stronger tropical storm by Thursday. Then by the time it makes its way to the Windward Islands, that's when it's going to become a weak Category 1 hurricane, and then eventually weaken back down to a tropical storm by the time it makes its way to the Dominican Republic. Now, right behind that, we have another system that we're watching, a wave off the coast of Africa. Medium chance of development here. This could likely become another tropical depression over the next couple of days. But back here in town tomorrow, mostly cloudy in the morning, only some isolated showers, more widespread storms by later on in the afternoon, temperatures making it into the low 80s. Very high rain chances all week long, anywhere from 60 to 80%, with temperatures below average, as low as 80 degrees on Thursday, warming up back to 90 next Monday, but still below average. So here's the system. It's going to meander back and forth across the southeast, warm front across our area, bringing rounds of storms tomorrow. Not expecting any severe weather, though. Then by Wednesday afternoon, same situation. So just these on and off rounds of showers and thunderstorms into Thursday and eventually Friday as well. Here's a closer look at home at midnight. As I mentioned, we will see some of those showers in Emanuel County expand. I do think this is a little bit overdone, though. Overall tonight, mostly just the clouds, 7 a.m., no rain to interrupt your morning commute. Then by the afternoon, though, we will see more storms popping up, pretty scattered in nature, continuing all the way through the evening. Another dry start on Wednesday morning, but then we'll see more waves of rain and storms coming through later on in the day as well. Your 10-day forecast showing a lot of high rain chances, temperatures in the low 80s, lows in the upper 60s, and a bit of a warm-up next week. Back to you, Dee.
All right, thanks so much, Jenna. Summertime is fun and games for
access to a doctor's office while at work at no cost to you. Work schedules to fit your lifestyle, matched 401k to prepare you for retirement, paid vacation, and more. A company that you can count on and grow with. A company that you can have a career with. An employer like Amick Farms. Visit countonamick.com to apply today.
Well, last but not least, Snapchat is launching a new augmented reality feature to honor the history of Juneteenth.
It allows users to take a glimpse into the past to see a black community that was there previously.
Rich DeMuro explains.
So we've crossed the street, and what are we coming up to now?
So currently, it's Herman's Auto Body, but it used to be Juanita's Beauty Shop.
Imagine a walking tour where the buildings you're looking at come to life.
So this was a major kind of hangout area, and then it also was the meat market for the community.
Jason Crockett is with Snapchat. He's showing me a new augmented reality experience called Broadway to Freeway. It tells the story of a thriving community of color in Santa Monica before a freeway development erased it.
I think it's critical because so many people don't know the history of their own local communities.
To access the tour, you scan a QR code or open the Snapchat app and look for the lens, which is being released to honor Juneteenth.
We thought it was the right time to partner with the city and other stakeholders like Calvary Baptist Church to be able to elevate this story in a moment of celebration and jubilee.
The tour has several stops on a map. You look through your phone to bring the history of the area to life with audio, photos, and more.
Looks like a lot of great information there. Wish that was here locally.
Yeah, really cool. You can do that through Snapchat, of all things.
Of all things.
Well, for a 10-day forecast, we're seeing a lot of rain chances, anywhere from 60 to 80% all week long. Our high temperatures will only be in the low 80s due to the cloudy skies and rain. 83 tomorrow, low temperatures in the upper 60s when you're waking up in the morning. Then as we go into the weekend, we'll slowly warm up, upper 80s, and then some low 90s next week with those rain chances going down just a little bit, but nonetheless, still a lot of rain in the forecast over the next several days.
Gonna need the rain gear if you're going to drive Chip and Butt.
I'll be out there with my umbrella or something watching my son. Let's cheer him on, send some prayers for him. Well, thanks so much for joining us. The news continues at the top of the hour at 11.
And Hogan's Heroes next, right here on MeTV.
That's gonna be one in your power play multiplier is 3.
Clouds are sticking around this week with on and off rain and thunderstorms. We do have the potential of some localized flooding as well over the next couple of days. I'll have all the details coming up.
Now at 11, how a local nonprofit plans to celebrate Juneteenth into the weekend. Plus, how some Augusta residents are tracing their lineage to the past. And the city of Augusta preparing to hire a new city administrator. We have the details and more headlines as your news at 11 starts now.
Live from Television Park, this is WJBF News Channel 6 at 11.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dee Griffin. Thanks so much for joining us. Coverage you can count on begins as a park activity center. Doors will open at 1 p.m. Time now for a first check of our forecast as everyone's planning the rest of their week. We hope rain doesn't get in the way, and meteorologist Jenna Petrocci is here with a look ahead for us. Jenna.
Well, Dee, we had a good amount of rain come down today, and we're actually still seeing some showers down in Jenkins and Screven County. Other than that, the rest of the CSRA looking good. A nice break from the rain, at least for now. But here's the latest on Live Viper 6. With a closer look now at Jenkins County, right outside of Millen, this heavy rain is coming down right along Highway 25, and this is moving off towards the northeast, so all of downtown Millen is about to get hit with some very heavy rain. One lightning strike, for the most part, this is just some rain, but definitely some thunderstorms possible as well over the next couple of hours, mostly in our southern counties. Other than that, scattered showers and storms across much of the two-state up into Tennessee and North Carolina as well. But over in Aiken, looking good. Our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview cam not showing any rain. Today's high temperature was only 85 degrees in Augusta, another below average day due to the rain and cloud cover. But right now, temperatures are on track with average, seeing those low 70s, a warm and muggy summer-like evening with very cloudy skies. 72 in Augusta, 73 in Bardwell, Louisville at 71. Pretty consistent temperatures here, all in those low 70s. Dew points also in the low 70s and upper 60s. So as I mentioned, very muggy, humid week in store for us with continued cloud cover and rain. There's the clouds on satellite and radar with a very active pattern across the southeast. Severe thunderstorm watch down in parts of the Gulf Coast. This is all due to this low pressure system with a warm front across our area, which will bring more showers and storms for us tomorrow. But for your morning, mostly cloudy skies, possibly an isolated shower or storm, but definitely not a washout when you're headed out the door, and expect those upper 60s as temperatures. So mostly cloudy and humid week, cooler temperatures only topping off in the low 80s with high rain chances all the way through the weekend. I'll have all the details on your forecast coming up, but back to you, Dee.
All right, Jenna, thanks so much. Well, Augusta.
Now, your most accurate forecast with WJBF Live Viper 6.
Good evening and welcome back. We had a soggy Monday morning with waves of rain and storms throughout the day. And now on Live Viper 6, we're still seeing some downpours in Jenkins and Screven County. The rest of the CSRA looking nice and dry now. But if you're in Millen, definitely some heavy rain coming down right now. Lightning counter up to 8 strikes over the last 15 minutes. So these storms are actually intensifying as they move off towards the northeast and expanding a little bit. So any of our southern line counties could be dealing with some rain over the next couple of hours. But the rest of the CSRA, as I mentioned, looking good. West Georgia pretty much dry, on and off showers and storms across much of the two-state, though, with some severe thunderstorm warnings right along the border of Mississippi and Louisiana. It's been a very active day across the southeast. Here in town, under a half an inch, but definitely some higher amounts just to our north and to the west. And check out the Gulf Coast, just in southern Alabama to the south of Mobile, nearly 12 inches of rainfall. So luckily for us, we had no flooding issues today, and even No strong to severe storms. Most of this was just a messy rain today. Now on our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview cam outside the station, you can actually see some of the clouds out there. Definitely a cloudy, warm, and muggy night. 72 degrees as our temperature with a south-southeast wind of 5 miles per hour. Dew point of 70. Right now, seeing all those low 70s, pretty consistent across the board here. 71 in Lincolnton, 70 in Gibson, 72 in Augusta, Waynesboro, 73 in Aiken and Bardwell, under those mostly cloudy skies. So Augusta, north of I-20, will stay dry until tomorrow afternoon. But we do still have this low pressure system across the area with a trailing warm front. And this is going to bring a lot of wet weather for us over the next several days. So notice in parts of Alabama, Mississippi, it's actually pretty dry. And that's what's reflected here on our water vapor loop. You can see that counterclockwise spin here where that low pressure is located across Kentucky with some dry air wrapped around it. But for our neck of the woods, a lot of moisture around, and all that tropical moisture will provide the chance of rain and storms over the next few days. So this is the key player. It's going to become a cutoff low, which will linger in the area. Now, more on that to come, but let's switch gears to the tropics. We had Tropical Storm Brett form today. Right now, winds are at 40 miles per hour. This is the latest 11 p.m. advisory. It is going to strengthen eventually up to 70 mile per hour winds by Wednesday morning. And then will become a Category 1 hurricane as it makes its way towards the Caribbean. So luckily, by the time it makes its way towards the Dominican Republic, though, it is starting to weaken back down to a tropical storm. Right behind that, we have another system we're watching, a wave off the coast of Africa that will likely become a depression over the next couple of days. Now, here in town tomorrow, mostly cloudy in the morning, rain and storms returning around the 2 o'clock hour as temperatures make it into the low 80s. Tonight at midnight, this is showing a lot of rain and storms. As I mentioned, I think this will stay south of Augusta, so this is a little bit overdone. Then when you're headed out the door tomorrow morning, just the clouds, no rain until we go into the afternoon. Then these storms come in from the west, very scattered in nature, not as widespread, no severe thunderstorm threat, and the flooding threat remains low. But as we add more chances of rain as we go into Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, we will have the possibility of some isolated flooding. So rainfall totals today or tonight through tomorrow will top off around 1/2 inch all the way to 2 inches. Definitely those higher amounts towards the south could see up to 3 inches as we go into Wednesday evening. Your 10-day forecast showing some very high chances of rain, anywhere from 60% to 80%. High of 83 tomorrow, low 80s all week long. Over the weekend, we'll start to warm up a bit, upper 80s and low 90s next week, with those rain chances going down just a tad. But overall, a very rainy week, and even rainy next week as well.
Wow, but I'm loving the low 80s.
I know, it's surprising for June, for
yes,
sure.
It is. All right, thanks so much. Well, pickleball is the fastest growing sport in America. Wow. Well, coming up, a local baseball player starts in the College World Series, and we visit with USC Aiken basketball coach Mark Vanderslice at his kids camp.
WJBF Headlines on News Channel 6, brought to you by Jamie Casino Injury Attorneys. Now, WJBF sports coverage you can count on.
Summer camp season is in full swing over at the Convocation Center. USC Aiken men's basketball coach Mark Vanderslice hosting his annual kids camp, where Kira Goldstein stopped by to check it out.
Head coach of the USC Aiken men's basketball team, Mark Vanderslice, is hosting a clinic this week as a way to get kids more involved in basketball.
So fun, fundamentals and fun is what we, what our central theme is. So we want the kids to learn something. We want them to take something away at the end of every single camp. We want to be able to say, hey, what did you learn today? And then at the end of the day, we want them to have fun. It's all about having a great time and enjoying yourself, making friends at camp, but at the same time, learning a lot about the game itself, and that's important.
Kids of all ages are encouraged to sign up for the next camp, which will start in July.
So our camps are from 8 to 16. It's co-ed, so boys and girls, and we go beginners, intermediate, advanced. So next camp is going to be July 10th to the 13th, Monday through Thursday, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Sign up on our website, register at markvanderslicebasketballcamps.com.
From USC Aiken, Kira Goldstein, WJBF, News Channel 6.
Looks like a good time. And the road to the Drive, Chip and Putt National Finals underway across the country here in Augusta. One of the first local qualifiers will take place Tuesday at Champions Retreat. Boys and girls ages 7 to 15 going to compete in the three major disciplines, and the winners in each boys and girls age division will advance to the regional qualifiers. Good luck. At the College World Series, that's former Greenbrier High School alum Chase Dolander. He got the start for the Volunteers in an elimination game against Stanford. He's the 2022 SEC Pitcher of the Year, likely a first-round draft pick, but didn't have the day he was hoping for. Went three innings, gave up four runs on four hits, a couple of strikeouts, but his Volunteers had his back. Down 4-0, they scored six unanswered runs, and Chase Burns was brilliant in relief. Six innings, nine strikeouts. Tennessee wins 6-4. They and Dolander move on. They'll take on LSU in an elimination game Tuesday at 7. And it was an off night for the Braves, but they're red hot ahead of their series in Philadelphia. They've gone 13-3 so far in June, winning streaks of 7 games, and their current 6-game winning streak as well. During the weekend series sweep of the Rockies, each starting pitcher earned a win. The list includes former Green Jacket A.J. Smith, Schauber, Schuster, Elder, and Charlie Morton. Tells you everything you need to know about the injury issues they've dealt with, and how the rotation is answering. But best of luck tomorrow. One particular drive to
That's right. Send up some prayers for Pierce. My son is in drive chip and fun again. I'm rooting for him. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
All right. Well, your news at 11 returns. How one bookmobile helped many students learn and take part in some activities.
I'm Attorney George,
News Channel 6.
More than 5,000 books were given away in New York City this weekend to help kids learn about Juneteenth. Neat Bookmobile, which was made out of a converted school bus, works like a museum. The bus helps kids have some creative and positive fun this summer by helping them learn about history and by making reading an exciting activity.
Wow,
very neat idea. Pretty cool. I used to love the Bookmobile.
Yeah,
the book fair at school.
And the book fair, that's right.
Yeah, I've never been to a Bookmobile, but those Scholastic book fairs back in school, where you could
really
also buy like the pens, the fun pens.
Yep, that was so
all
cool.
Those goodies.
Ask mom for the money.
Of course.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, for books, but then you end up buying a bunch of the other
Exactly, and that's my son. I always gets other stuff.
Yeah, I don't blame him. But for forecast this week, we're going to see a lot of rain. Those chances stay around 60 to 80% all week long, mostly cloudy skies. High temperatures only topping off in the low 80s. It'll be very muggy, though, so feeling warmer than the actual air temperature. And then over the weekend, we'll make it into the upper 80s. Rain chances still staying pretty high. And next week, we'll be at that 90-degree mark.
All right. Well, there you have it. And thank you so much for joining us for this edition of Eyewitness News. And we really appreciate you. Oh, not Eyewitness News. I went back to my Hartford, Connecticut days.
I was just going with it.
News Channel 6.